Sustainable development and urban coastal communities faces a range of challenges. In my project, I'm going to explore examples of sustainable development in our city of Brighton Hove and identify the projects that have worked and those that may need more strategic thinking. Our city is nestled in between the South Downs and the sea, an area of outstanding natural beauty. It is no coincidence that it is also recognised as one of the UNESCO biosphere regions and, in this area, covers 150 square miles and is known as the Living Coast. What I mean by sustainable development is a definition given in the 1987 United Nations World Commission report on environment and development and focuses on the goal of socially inclusive and environmentally sustainable economic growth, thereby taking care of the triple bottom line of social, economic and environmental factors. These principles need to be integrated into all aspects of decision making in town planning and development. Green Wall along East Brighton is just one example of sustainable development and it is a good illustration of a project breathing life into the city. I would explore some dynamic approaches such as the rewilding of green spaces and the use of green walls and roofs and look at potential further opportunities for designers in coastal communities. And I will question how far regenerative design can address the social and economic needs of an area and as well as looking at environmental factors. I would explore some fine examples of polycentricity and regenerative design at work, including projects such as the Brighton Waste House, Earthship at Stammer Park, the Butterfly Bank, and the Rampion Offshore Wind Farm. Regenerative design, the social economy and the sustainable management of the commons in Brighton Hove illustrate how designers are developing responses that enable coastal communities to adapt to the impact of climate change, including rising sea levels and temperatures, social changes such as homelessness and economic uncertainty. I want to explore some of these responses, showing some of the solutions which have worked and the wide range of resources which have been used, and assess which areas of sustainable development in urban coastal communities might need further development and thinking. Regenerative design has been seen as the answer to Garrett Hardin's questions around this theory of the commons. I want to show how these possible answers work in a coastal community, how to mix public, private and community interests and how they work together to get the best out of a locality and to ask what we are protecting. Green roof at the level is another example of sustainable development at the heart of our city. there are dozens of other examples, but one question remains: is the strategy of sustainable development in a city a coherent one? Is there more which can be done?